Do you have sites built with WordPress? Well, chances are you probably already have a security plugin. That security plugin has a firewall, a malware scanner, a brute force attack system, but it doesn't have something. It doesn't hide the fact that you're actually using WordPress. Now you're gonna ask yourself, well, why do I care about that? If you check your security plugin analytics right now, you're gonna find out that you're always trying to get hacked. Why is that? Because there's hacker bots that are looking for WordPress sites. So how do we prevent most of these attacks? Well, let's hide the fact that we're using WordPress. There's a deal that's called Hide My WP Ghost, which does exactly that. It's gonna complement your security plugin to hide the fact that you're using WordPress. So let me show you what the deal's about and how it actually works. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. All right, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it starts off at $59 for the lifetime deal. So that means you pay once and you can use it forever. And if you guys want to grab that deal, that link will be in the description, okay? Let me show you what this deal actually gets you. There's the first code stack that is $59 and it gets you 10 sites. I don't recommend it unless you don't plan to go over 10 sites, okay? The plan I do recommend is the double stack, which is unlimited sites. You can install it for yourself, for your clients, and you just get unlimited sites. Now, there's a triple code that enables white label. Now, if you don't need white label, if you don't need to hide the fact that you're using this plugin for your clients, you're definitely good with the double stack. So no need to waste a little bit of more money to grab the white label. So I recommend double code. Unless you need white label, then jump to three codes, all right? Now, I mentioned in the beginning that you probably already have a security plugin. In this case, this is one of my sites. I have WordFence installed. And if you're not using a security plugin, please install one. It doesn't matter which one, but just install one, okay? So this is WordFence, and you're gonna find out that you're always trying to get attacked from people. Even if your site's not popular, there's always hacker bots trying to hack you. And if they find a way, they're gonna hack your site, they're gonna take it down, and you're gonna have a big problem, all right? So go to your security plugin if you have one, and you're gonna find out that you're always getting hacked. And that's a fact that they know that you're using WordPress. So this is where WP Hide Ghost comes in, all right? It hides the fact that you're using WordPress and you're going to prevent most of these hacks because they're not gonna know that you're using WordPress, okay? Now, this is a blank site. It's my test site. There's nothing installed but my theme. So I just installed this plugin, all right? Which is Hide My WP Ghost. Nothing's going on. It says my security is weak. I don't even have another security plugin, which I should, but this is just a test site, okay? Like I mentioned before, they do complement each other because security plugins are not meant to hide the fact that you're using WordPress. That's not why they're built, okay? So this is why it complements. So I'm getting some information here that I'm saying, hey, fix this stuff because it's your site is very weak. So let's go into the settings, all right? There's the overall setting here from features, but we're gonna go into the main settings over here in the menu, all right? So first off, the level of security is deactivated. We have the safe mode, which changes, first of all, the link that you're using to log in. So to log into your site, you go to wp/login, wp/admin, and hacker bots know that. And even hackers who want to hack your site know that. So that's the first thing that we have to work on is change that link. So if I click on safe mode, it's gonna change the paths to all of these. So for example, my new login path will be new login. Now heads up, you need to remember that you have a new login link so you don't forget, okay? And it changes other paths also for content, includes, uploads, author, and all of those, okay? To hide all those little weak points where the hacker bots will find out that it's a WordPress site. I can activate it, but before I do, there's another option, which is ghost mode. Again, this is another type of change the path links, but we're going to use the safe mode, all right? We're not gonna go overboard with this. It's going to update once I click save. Let's go ahead and save it, okay? And now we have a new login site, URL, okay? So it's this one right here, new login. Let's go check it out. Let's go open an incognito mode. Let's go into the login site. And there it is. Now, before what I used was wp-admin. But guess what? Now it takes me to the homepage. It doesn't work anymore. And if I go to wp-login, not found, .php goes to login page. So now we just hided the fact what the login URL is. So that's one of the most important parts, okay? And in case you can't log in, use this safe URL. So you want to save this URL in a notepad, somewhere where you can have it if you just forget what that link is. But you're gonna get used to it once you start using it. And you can customize what that login is also. Okay, and we can use Simulate CMS. So right now it's simulating Drupal 8, but you could change another one if you like. Okay, if we're good to go, it's yes, it's working. We just tested it. So we have the new login site. Next thing is the admin security. So we can custom admin path if we like, okay? If we wanna change this one, remember we tested it and it's not working. If I wanna use a custom one, I can do so right here. I can hide WP admin. I can hide WP admin from non-admin users, which also I would say save, all right? Login security. Again, we can change the login custom path. You saw that it was new login, but if you're used to using something more common to you, well, use something else. Maybe you're using login to my site, and that's probably what you're used to on your other WordPress sites or something like that. Well, you can customize your own. Let's keep it how it is. We can hide wp-login. We tested it also, it's hidden. Hide the login path. Custom lost password path, we can customize that. Custom registered path, custom logout path. And we can customize all these permalinks for that, okay? So they don't find which links you're using. Ajax security, custom Ajax path if we like. Again, we can customize it. Hide WP admin Ajax, change the path to Ajax calls. And every single one of these settings has this little question mark. If we click on it, it's gonna give us details of what it's for and what it's going to do. So it's pretty cool that they took the time to actually do that, because there's some of these things that you're not going to know what it's for, even me, all right? Because I'm not dedicated to hacking sites. I'm not even a white hat hacker. So some of these settings, you'll have to find out what they're for. Custom author path, okay? It's changed to writer. All right, you can hide it. WP core security. Again, we can hide all of these. Hide WordPress common paths. I would suggest yes. So we wanna hide all of these. Make sure that everything is working fine and it's not interfering with your SEO plugin that you might have because it's changing paths. And we can hide all these type of files, okay? Hide WordPress common files. That's enabled already. Disable directory browsing. Let's go ahead and enable it. Plugin security. Again, custom plugin path. Instead of saying plugins, well, it's saying modules. So it's hiding everything that it might try to find. And you can customize this to whatever you like. So modules, plugins, so you don't forget what it's for. But it's just different to what HackerBots are used to looking for. Hide all the plugins. Hide WordPress old plugin paths. Show advanced options. So customize plugin names. So right now I only have one plugin installed, but I can customize what the name is. So if HackerBots are looking for specific plugins because they know they have vulnerabilities, well, they're gonna not know because you're changing that name to it, okay? Let's go ahead and save it. Theme security, again, we can change the information for this. Custom theme path, so it's changed to views instead of, you know what? We can change that also, aspect, template, styles instead of themes. Hide themes name, hide WordPress old themes past, yeah, path. Custom theme style name, so it's changed to design. Show advanced options, custom theme names. So again, for example, I have installed Divi, Astra, and Cadence. If I'm using Divi, well, I don't want to have them find what I'm using, all right? So I'm using, I don't know, custom theme, blah, blah, blah. All right, so it's not gonna say Divi anymore. So the HackerBot won't find out it's using Divi. So it's trying to see where they might look for so you don't find out. API security, custom WP JSON path. I really recommend that you check if it doesn't interfere with other plugins because they might be using this, okay? Hide REST API URL, disable REST API access, disable XML RPC access. So you're good to go with all of these. You can go ahead and save them. Firewall and header. Security changes that happen right here, strict transport security, context security policy, and all these options, okay? You can have these, check out these little warnings because they might interfere with other things. Remove unsafe headers, block theme detector crawlers, beta, firewall against script injection, you can save that. Other options, custom category path, custom tags, and all those options. Now let's jump into the tweaks category. I'm not saving because this is just a test site. Tweaks, all right, redirect hidden path to front page. So remember when they tried to, I tried to log into the site with the old login path, it took me to the front page. But what if I want to change it to a 404 page or demo home or whatever page you have, you can send them there. Do login or and log out redirects, and save that. Mapping. Oh, I have some tweaks over here, my bad. Going back to tweaks. The feed and sitemap, so you can hide the sitemap links tags. So this is the sitemap that it comes with, but we can change it, change the path to RSS feed so they don't know what the RSS feed and they don't feed from it. Change path to sitemap XML. Again, make sure that it's not interfering with SEO plugins, that your Google webmaster does know what the site path URL is. Hide the path in robot.txt. Change options for path login users, change relative URL to absolute URLs, hide options, so you can hide the admin bar, hide version from images, yep, the version CSS and JS in WordPress, hide the ID from meta tags, hide WordPress DNS, a lot of options that are really useful. Hide emojicons, hide embedded scripts. Let's go into mapping. No. I'm still over here. Why do I want to get out of here? Disable options. This one is really useful. I think this could be useful for most of us. For example, if you want to disable right click from the website so they don't steal your images, so they don't copy and paste and all of that. Disable inspect elements, disable view source, disable copy paste. So you saw that that's disabled and they're going to get a message if they try to do it. I mean, it doesn't hide the fact it's probably Chrome extensions will still work. That's my thought. But it's good to have it, okay? Disable drag and drop images, disable debug in front page, all right? Mapping, let's go ahead and leave this here. And we have more options again for text mapping. Instead of WP-caption, it's gonna be only caption, or unless you change it to something custom that you might know, WP custom, change another one, and map all the type of links that you're using. URL mapping, again, you can use your customize. For example, they give you an example. You can change this to this or this to this, all right? So custom URLs, change one to another. CDN, if you have other apps using CDN, then you can customize it here. Experimental, optimize CSS and JS files, text mapping and CSS. Heads up, I don't recommend that you tweak this if you have a cache plugin, all right? So if you don't have a cache plugin, then go ahead and use these for optimization, but make sure they're not breaking your site. So go ahead and test it in incognito mode before you set this site to live and just use it as it is. Now let's go into brute force. These are the brute force options that it gives you. If you have a security plugin that is working fine and it has brute force attack prevention system, then you don't need to enable this. But if you're not using that, then go ahead and enable it. So it removes the way for hackers to just try to hack into your site by brute force, okay? So you can do max file attempts. So you can set it to 5, 10, 20, whatever you want to set it. The ban duration, how many seconds do you want to ban them? So that'll be the next time they'll try to log in. Again, for yourself, if you miss the login attempt for 5 times, you're gonna have to wait this amount of seconds. So be aware of that, unless you have that link that they provide to log in, all right? Lockout message, whitelist IPs. So if you know what your IP is, your teammate, your virtual assistant, or whatever, add this IP here and they won't get blocked, okay? Banned IPs, if you know that there's a list of IPs that you need to ban, well, just list them here. If you want to enable Google reCAPTCHA V2 or V3, this is available, but you will have to get the CAPTCHA information, the site key for these, okay? It's super easy to do. There's several tutorials on doing this. I recommend that you actually enable this, right? You can see the event logs right here. We shouldn't have any events logs because this is just a test site. So log users events. And do you want to log? You want to see the logs for these type of user roles? You can enable that. Security checks. Let's go ahead and check that out. So here's a security check of what's going on your site. So what PHP version are you using? MySQL version. So we're valid with all of these. And we're seeing some information here. For example, database prefix. Hey, it's using WP. There's a vulnerability there that HackerBots will find out that you're using WordPress because it's using that. So go into info and customize it so it doesn't start with WP underscore, all right? Security key updates, here's the setting, the recommendations and information to know what it's for, all right? So you can do it. Some of these will have the fix it, so because I didn't enable these, I'm doing a test site, but they tell you what is going on here and you can go ahead and fix it and then start a scan again, all right? There's the plugins settings right here that they recommend. These guys are the same ones from SEO Squirrely, which is really popular, right? And there's all their popular plugins that they are recommending. Let's see if they're recommending a security plugin here. Security, iTheme Security. So these are two security plugins that they are recommending. WordFence works fine if you guys want to use that. Backup and restore, it just backs up the settings from this plugin. It's not a backup or restore plugin completely, all right? It just backups the settings from this. It might work if you already set the settings here and you wanna use it on another WordPress site that you installed this plugin, then it's pretty useful to save time and just punch in the settings that you already have from a backup. Advanced, there's the advanced settings, rollback settings to custom save URL parameter. Compatibility with managed WP plugins, late loading, clean login page, email notifications if you want to get notified from changes with the changed admin and login URLs. If it changes, you're going to get an email notification, which I think is pretty useful. And then my account to jump in to hide my WP Ghost account, which we're not going to go there. But like I mentioned before, this plugin complements with your other security plugin. Now, why do other security plugins don't have these settings? Or they do have some, but not as complete as this one? Because like I mentioned before, they are not meant to hide using WordPress. They are just meant to provide security. They're providing firewall, a malware scanner, and a brute force attack prevention system, and a few settings. But they're not meant to hide the fact they're using WordPress. So this one comes in handy to prevent most of those brute force attacks by just hiding the fact that you're using WordPress. So there you go. Like I mentioned before, it's a lifetime deal that's going on right now. $118 is the sweet deal for unlimited sites. So if you guys want to grab it, that link will be in the description. It's an affiliate link. If you buy through that link, it helps me out with a small commission, but it won't cost you a single cent more. What it already costs, it's going to cost you, but it helps me with a small commission to keep on making videos for you guys. I thank you all for watching. My name is George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.